I'm going to check the chart and then the policy on the patient's room. And then we'll be asked to pay my open the door. And inside, I'm going to put this myself. I'm not sure. I'm more.
So, open the door.
Okay.
Knock on the door.
Good afternoon, my name is Wally. I'm here for the caregiver today. We're going to get the vital signs. So we start your temperature, pulse rate, test pressure, and let's hear about blood pressure. So after that, I'm going to ask the patient's name and their date to confirm the status the patient is the one. We're going to provide a service or get the vital signs. After that, place the patient into a comfortable position. Prefer the upright position. Position the patient in a comfortable position.
How are you today? Do you have anything to do before we proceed with vital signs
meeting? After asking my patient if you have something else to do before taking the vital signs, proceed with getting his or her vital signs. Just before that, make sure that you are the door is closed or the door is supposed to provide privacy. And then after that, you should take in first the thermometer. I mean the temperature of the patient. Make sure na naka-open yung third or yung platform thermometer. Make sure that then after that, make sure na nalabas mo lang ng mask or sir na malamig for yung cold part. May natatawag siyang cold, which is yung tip ng ating brain. Then after that, you can proceed with getting the pulse rate of the patient. So placing 2 to 3 minutes of the
emergency. You want to do the mask?
During the mask? Okay. And then, see by placing your index and the finger of the layer pulse. Then count for 1 to 8. Count up. So after that, before receiving the pwede tayo mag-proceed sa pagsuhan ng kanyang without moving our hands or our fingers from her palate para hindi ma-distract yung patient. Ngayon, raise your pulse. So, just give it out for what we're doing and check his or her chest. Thank you.
Ano niya ang nangyayakan ng Indonesia?
Ang yung temperature is 6.3. Tanda din po ako sa
And it's normal. You have to know the normal, okay?
Yes,
normal ranges. Because you can never tell kung abnormal o normal, pwede mo naman normal. Diba? O hangin din ang makasabi mo, your temperature is 37.8, it's normal. Wow, may conviction ka pa rin.
And then next is, I know in yung respiratory disease, pwedeng samples per liter, that's per minute, and then yung positive is 7 degrees. Okay, naman na naman yung mga parts. Next month is kukunin na sa natin yung blood pressure. So after that, before proceeding with getting the blood pressure patient, we will inverse the thermometer use. So, as I said before, we will open it from the digestion, at least in the test. Now, we start from the slab, which is about the second one.
Since it's already used, then it's ready.
Then, we have the patient. After that, we need to get the moon up. And, of course, we
start. After ito,
So we want to come to the arm parts that we want to make just on the front of us. As a patient,
you can also, what are you going to use when you're going to get the patient? You are going to? Let's say for example, left arm. Paano mo nakoto ng left arm niya? Paano nakoto na parang yung arm niya? So yan natin, depende sa affected part. Kasi kung yan, sa kaswere yung pasyente natin. Doon kayo lagi sa unaffected side. Paano kung affected pa rin mo, may swero, tapos may fistula yung isang kamina? Ano nga gamitin? Pwede na tayo stand the swero. Never kayo magbibiti sa may fistula. Yung fistula kasi, pwede na tayo sa swero. Kasi yung fistula, hindi natin pwede gamitin yun kasi pwede natin masira. Ginagamit kasi yun sa dialysis.
So sa swero. So ma'am, hindi naman possible na dalawa yung fistula yun.
Possible. Pero yung ano, yung sira na buka sa sira ang fistula.
Usually yung mga dialysis patient, po is lumalakad po yung mga veins mo na okay lang po na lagyan ng
pag sira na yun, di ba?
Pero pwede po siyang lagyan.
Sira na yun, pwede.
So, and the patient that we're going to roll her sleeves up.
Kaysa doon sa hindi pupunta ka doon sa hindi sima. Mamaya sinira mo nga ulit.
Make sure that two fingers is...
That is too loose.
And then add gloves.
Dali pa ka para hindi ka nila mga
Sa test na matulos. And then case,
never forget, the brachial pulse is located ito. This is your radial opposite. Naging yung opposite ng finger nyo. Malulocate nyo naman. Ang landmark nito, this is your, what do you call this? Your? Your? Okay, antecubital.
Fossa. So to make sure that diaphragm is strong, so to send it back in there.
Don't use the finger when you're going to cover. This is the thumb.
So use your index palm and secure your hands.
Never the thumb, kasi magkaranjin for sound. Thank you. Rejab. Sound mo rejab.
Then close the doors.
Open chair. When you are getting the vital signs, you both of you should also come forward. So, sinari namin dito papa ako. Never do na magbibipi kayo na matay yung pasyente.
And then fast, until no longer can be bit. And then add 20 to 30 PSI.
Lunch time pa si Chris? No, lunch time pa no. Mamaya na ako.
Lunch time.
Ano sinabi ni sir? Ano sinabi ni sir? Susunod na?
Your bill is 100 over 80 milligram of millimeter of milligram. So, normal naman ko.
Milliliter.
Milliliter. Where is it? Especially yung ating heart pump. So then, seven alcohol. Then light.
When did you start on the cough? Bleed is tuberculosis, right?
Okay.
So you're going to start with the
gauge.
After, before you use, you can start with the cough. But after you use, marumi na yung cough kasi binigit mo sa pasyente. So you start with the
gauge. Start from the gauge, going down, and then pump. Going down, and then pasyente.
Spray.
Arm up.
And just spray the arm up.
Yes. And spray the arm up. And then, basically, the thin area or thin surface. So that in the stethoscope, starting from the penis, which is the earpiece, localized on the balls, deep, going down to the tube. Start. And then, the bell end and the diaphragm. Then light, using diaphragm on this. After that, you can
do the documentation.
And do the documentation. And then after that, hand wash the documentation.
This time, kung ano kasi, ang ano natin is...
Baka mag...
Yan lang natin sabihin mo na do unwashing and do the
okay. Then after cleaning of the
unwashing,
do hand washing and washing. And then tell the patient. And yung kasabi ko.
Paano na lang sa patient?
Yes. Kasi,
so after the procedure, you can also tell the patient. Okay. So ang dami ng procedure, you can just leave you. Okay, you need to take rest. Not rest in peace.